Good evening, everybody. Welcome to eCurious Minds. We are reading Trevor's new book on assessment, chapter 2. And today's session leaders are Nanta and Sapna. Over to you.
You need to enable me.
Sure.
Here you go. Nanta and Sapna, take over, please.
Yeah. Yes. So welcome, everyone. Miss Nanta, should I don't know. I cannot see Pallavi.
I was on mute. Is my screen visible to everyone?
Yes, we can see you.
A very warm and sunny welcome from Gurgaon. I'm Nanta from Gurgaon and Sapna, please.
And hi, Sapna, everybody. From Mumbai. Thank you, eCurious Mind. So here we are to be the change, to bring the change.
The agenda for today's evening is understanding, showing our understanding and discussing our perspectives about nurture student ownership of assessment, the second chapter of the book Inquiry Mindset by Trevor McKenzie. In this chapter, Trevor talks about, he's speaking basically about inquiry thrives when we plan intentionally provide opportunities and not by throwing our kids into the deep end of the inquiry pool or by backing away from learning entirely. Inquiry thrives, he says, inquiry thrives as we become partners in learning. I hope we all agree with this thought. How? My next is where everybody would need to reflect how.
Yes, and we can use the chat box.
Or you can raise your hand so that we can ask you. Or you can unmute yourself and speak. How does inquiry thrive as we become partners in learning?
Yeah, may I?
Yeah.
Yes, miss.
Yeah, so see, the very word inquiry means questions. So when you have a question or when you have a question answer, you know, a format or a way of learning, then both the people have to be partners for it to be constructive or creative. It cannot be like the teacher only is asking questions and the students are only answering, or only the students are asking and we are. When both the sides are equal partners, you know, in asking questions and in constructing the learning, that's how then you become partners in learning. That is what I understand.
Great. Ruchi Gargia writes, Pallavi writes, we are all stakeholders in inquiry. Jayashree writes, inquiry is questioning, which is possible only when we believe that students are partners in learning. Unlike empty vessels to be filled with content, inquiry is thinking, questioning, asking, listening, and reflecting, which happens only when the stakeholders are partners. Nisha, you would like to say?
I just would like to add that it prompts thinking, because somewhere if it's not a partnership, if it's one way, then if the child gets stuck or if the teachers are not prompting them to think, then you know, it just becomes a one-way traffic. But because it's a partnership, you're just guiding each other, pushing each other. When you don't know where to go, you nudge the person. So that's how it becomes a partnership.
Pallavi, so, you'd like to add something?
I would just like to add to what Nisha has said. She's covered most of it. The student efficacy goes up when we talk of partnership, when we talk that all of us are equal stakeholders. That's it.
Monica is writing, we as teachers need to be inquirers to delve deeper and understand learners' perspective. Second that, Anri, when we move away from the traditional way of learning and teaching, we become partners. Having an open space where we create our learning, inquiring into the provided framework, understanding perspectives and different ways of progressing and thinking. Very well said. We can Swati. Take one more, Ms. Nanta.
Swati is raising her hand.
Oh, I cannot see.
Swati, please go ahead and put your keep your camera on, please.
Unmute yourself, Swati.
Swati, can you hear us? Unmute and keep the camera on.
So I was looking at the statement, inquiry thrives when we become partners in learning. So I was focusing on the word partners. So when does one become partner? So that was a thought that was coming to me. So partnership would be at different levels, right? From deciding, as we all know, it's not a new thought, but I'm just linking it to this statement that we become partners with students when we together decide what is going to be inquired into, how is it going to be inquired into, and how will we know that we have, taken the inquiry further. So those were my thoughts about this, and I thought I would share that.
True. We can take one more, Ms. Nanta.
Yeah, we can, and then we move on.
Yes, building relationship to become partners. Yes, Ms. Purti. To me, it's a journey for teacher, student as a community of learners. Great.
We move on to the next slide now.
Yes, Ms. Nanda. So yes, how do we nurture ownership of assessment? As we all have read the chapter and we have come to Curious Minds, so we would like you to share. There's a question put up. How do we nurture ownership of assessment? There is a question on this Mentimeter. I have posted it on the chat box. Please join with the code 363-9584.
You need to go onto the next window and type www.menti.com and use the code, or you can scan through your phones also the code that has been given, the scan code that has been given, and you can land through your mobiles also, whichever is convenient to you.
Ms. Nanta, you want me to share my screen for the cloud?
Yeah, here, yes.
Is it visible?
Yeah, it is visible. You need to present, make it on present mode.
Yes. Collaboration, giving responsibilities, agency, metacognition, self-assessment, voice choice, agency. Wow. Peer assessment, very, very important. Yes, partnership. Clear guidelines, very important again.
Even process over product and co-designing, delegation of tasks, scaffolding and modeling.
We have read the chapter very well, and we do implement all this in and out of our classrooms. Scaffolding and modeling. Co-design, feedback, co-constructing. So we all are thinking at the same page. Ms. Nanta, would you like to go ahead?
Yeah, thank you so much for sharing.
Yes. Thank you everybody for your wonderful ideas.
Sapna, let's move forward.
Yes. So as we have read Trevor's book, Trevor's chapter 2, yes? So we are talking about the 10 steps where he has told us about how to nurture student ownership of assessment. So we are going to read out, we're going to talk about the 10 points right now. The first point I would like to take up, co-design and co-construct, expectations, goals, rubrics and learning. I think I can't see once. Second point, thinking routines, reflection, and metacognitive strategies, which we all implement in the classrooms. Set personalized goals and plan the process. Ask ungoogliable questions, very important, and that's where we prompt the thinking routines. Use feedback to identify and plan next steps.
Relationships pave the way for meaningful assessment. Peer and self-assessment skills, process over product, collaborating and conferring about learning. And the last one is student voice in reporting.
So if you could see the picture in the screen, above all, if you can see the student is standing, the agency, the equity, equality, and empathy, which we all implement in our classroom as a homeroom teachers. So now here is a task for all of us. We will get into the breakout room for 20 minutes. We will design a subject, wise assessment, in your group.
The subjects further, will be assigned to you.
Yes, the subjects will be assigned to all of you. What steps you will follow and how? You will choose any 3 steps in nurturing student ownership of assessment. You will choose a leader in your breakout room to present your collaborative task. You will get 2 to 3 minutes for the presentation.
While constructing your assessment, you will be using the thinking routine, think, feel, care, and keeping the SEL for children when you're designing co-constructing. So you'll keep social emotional learning in mind while you're co-constructing this task. And the link, Sapna, can you share the link?
Yes, I have pasted it.
You can copy the Google Slides and make your own presentation on it.
How many breakout rooms do you want? We have 42.
Five.
All right.
Eight or nine in a group.
All right. So here you go. Would you like to tell them group number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? What
group number one? Your group one number one. Your subject will be English. Group number 2, your subject will be math. Group number 3, unit of inquiry. Group number 4 can take art. It's your choice whether you want to take visual art or performing art. And group number 5, PSPE.
Just write it in the chat box as well.
Do you want us to repeat it?
Okay. Jayashree has done that. Thank you, Jayashree.
Okay. Thank you, Jayashree.
All right. I'm opening up the rooms. Please join your rooms.
Yeah.
Nahida, join the room.
Chat box here. Yeah, it's visible here in the chat box.
It is. You can open
the chat. Yeah,
your group number 1.
English. Yeah.
English.
Yeah. So where we can take the slides.
So the 10 different steps, right? So how are you going to construct? co-construct. And so,
let's. Your so who's going to group number two?
Your math. Yeah, math. I would like to know one more time. Can you repeat the task, ma'am? Like,
okay. Don't mind. So there's a Google slide in the chat box. We have posted the task even in the Google slide. Still, I will explain. Think, yeah. Feel, and care. You need to use this thinking routine. Now, think is how do I feel about my teaching and learning practice right now? And your role.
Time before that. Criteria or a checklist, what is the learning of your children have, and under that, what the kids will be assessed for, correct? That which we can share with
you
them.
Are group number your group number three, UOI.
You are
right.
What are we going to assess? What will be the objective of the?
We can have some kind of a recitation of.
Yes, a recitation or
maybe recitation of poetry or something like that. I mean, you know, when children are doing some music, we can have. Yeah, we can have music also. Yeah.
You know, your group number four, right? Visual arts.
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
I think
I like what you said. Visual, performing arts. It'll put us on a page where we can all sing, where we can actually visualize and put in. Maybe if you're taking poems as a sing topic, and then we go with that.
Yeah, yes, we can do that.
Yes, we can have performing.
For meaningful assessment.
Relationship.
For meaningful assessment.
For meaningful assessment.
Your group number five, PSPP.
Yes.
And the next one is collaboration and conferring about
collaborating and conferring about learning.
And student-wise in reporting.
In?
Reporting.
All right.
Reporting.
REP. How about ungoogleable questions?
That is simple. Ungoogleable question is something that is very personal. I mean, something that you cannot easily.
For your perspective.
It's more conceptual
questions. Should also be moving, you know, from factual towards debatable, and conceptual questions are, especially the debatable ones, I would say, would be ungoogleable because it's a matter of perspective. So if you've chosen three, I think, Nisha, then we can move ahead with the PSP and just thinking about how we would. So what I understand, Nanta, is basically we have to design an assessment, right, in PSPE. Yeah. And we have to follow this routine, no? Think, feel, and
That is
And social emotional, as it is, comes with PSP only.
Which strand to take in PSP then in
Let's take active living. Identity becomes active living or interactions, both are good. Identity becomes difficult.
Maybe interaction, because we are talking about
so if we look at interactions, we look at teamwork, collaboration. Those are the concepts that come in interactions.
Yeah.
Following rules and regulation, leadership.
So now you have to design a task.
No, we have to design an assessment. So what are we assessing them for? Teamwork, following rules and regulation, leadership skills. If we have to look at the leadership skills and we have to look at teamwork, basically then the task needs to be, do we do an open-ended task? Or do we do a process-focused?
process focused. Process focused would be better.
Okay, so let's do process focus.
And also,
you said teamwork also, no? So the criteria to assess would be teamwork, following rules and regulations.
Yes, leadership qualities. So we are looking at process focus. So that means it's very clear that there has to be a process which needs to be followed to reach the goal, keeping those things in mind. Okay. So let's first design the assessment, then we'll look at the.
Yeah.
If we want the children to have leadership qualities, that can only be done if they if
they're given a problem. If they're given a problem and they look for a solution.
It could be a case study. It could be a real life case study. And again, we could build an agency here, you know, through a choice.
Did there anything happen recently in any sports? Cricket, what was the last thing by IPL was stopped because somebody...
No, that was COVID. Because of COVID. See, in tennis, recently what I remember is Naomi Osaka, and I think it goes well with the PSP thing. She has a lot of... She's an introvert. And she has a lot of anxiety where, you know, attending these press conferences, which is something which is mandatory. So she had to leave or she had to exit the French Open because she refused to come to a press conference saying, I have anxiety issues. Whereas she's a very good tennis player. So how would you resolve this issue? You know, being a good tennis player and attending press conferences have nothing to do with each other. So isn't it that, you know, the organization, I think now they are thinking about it, about changing some of these, you know, mandatory requirements. So do we think that if we pose this as a case study and then say that what is the process, how would you go about resolving and what do you think about it? So but again, then, it comes to...
Leadership, teamwork doesn't come. Then we are looking at... it's a problem and a solution.
Could be as, maybe as a team, how if we make students into groups... Then how is a team they are resolving this issue? So the team, this thing is for the students. I'm looking at it that way.
Nicolene, what are your inputs?
I love the idea of the tennis, and I'm thinking if you do put them in teams, and for me the leadership thing is. Because I'm talking in circles here in my own head, but yeah, like you say, for them to come up with a solution to how would she be able to perform if she maybe had a team behind her? So maybe we can sort of bring the teamwork in like that as well.
That's a great idea.
That's a very good.
I'm sure she. Yeah, I'm sure she must be having a trainer or a. I mean, they usually have people around them.
They have a whole team.
So the children can actually think about the team that she should have around her. It's a coach. So this. So can they not sort of coach her to also be more confident in front of cameras, that type of thing? So correct. Yes.
So a counselor, maybe some sort of a counselor on the team. I mean, I'm sure they have a definitely having, you know, somebody who's counseling them for this mental this thing. So this is something that the students can also think about, that look, if someone is, this could be like one of the case studies, that if someone is facing an issue like this and it falls into the this of a social emotional issue, then how do you resolve it?
So can we just put down the case study and then we pick up on these three strategies to help the children?
So what is the case?
I'm just trying to. I remember it was Naomi Osaka, and I remember it was French Open. I'm just trying to Google it. This is not ungoogleable.
Okay.
If I can get something, I'll put it on the chat. But this
all factual questions are googleable. This is factual. You will get it.
This is factual. Yeah. So I'm just copy pasting. So this is what I'm reading. Naomi Osaka withdrew from the. I mean, she had to withdraw from.
So just somebody put a message. Okay. So are you here, Pallavi? We can't write on this Google Doc. We are just wondering. Yeah, it's a view only for us. We are only one group. It's only view only.
The other groups have started to work.
Only one group. Maybe one of the, we are unable to do anything. You can open because we haven't shared with us.
I'll just come back to you. I'll just come back to you. Let me check with Sapna.
I'll send the request for editing access.
Just give me a minute. I'll come back.
Itself would explain their reason for choosing a person.
Sorry, Sapna, groups don't, all the groups don't have, they don't
access.
Have,
everyone has access. Everyone has
group
access.
Number one is not able to access it. Could you please look into it?
Just see, get link, copy link.
Could you share it in the chat box? Yeah, see, just make them enter. Done?
I'll just share it with you, 1 minute.
Just put it in the chat box. They're struggling.
Oh, sorry.
No problem. Just make them the editor, commentator, everything. All right. I'll just inform them.
1 second. What happened? My screen is hung. Yeah, Pallavi.
Done. Thanks. I'll just
thank you. Sorry for the trouble.
No problem.
We are looking at assessment.
Or maybe we can give them agency to them. Those who would like to write, they can write. Those who would like to present it orally, they can do that. And along choice. With that, you know, yes, choice. And we can incorporate the power concept, like POWER, plan, organize, write, and research and edit, if I'm right, the power concept that we usually give them to look back what they have done and how they can correct themselves.
This is a good one. Very good.
Yeah.
Because it will also about the process, right?
Yes. Yes.
So it's a choice board we're giving them, right?
Yes.
We can give them a choice board. Yeah.
Just to get back objective. You guys can see my screen, right?
Yes, we can see.
Now, objective is the elements of a story, am I right?
Yes.
Yes.
Sorry, I'm just taking notes here.
Sure.
Because I'm scared our time runs out. Our subject's English. Our age group?
Is this an open-ended or a closed-ended task?
It's lower priority,
I think. 6 to 8.
Oh. Chandrai, close-ended task, right?
Why should it be close-ended? It's open-ended.
It's open-ended.
Yeah.
But it's process-based.
Yes.
It's a process-based open-ended.
It is process-based, yeah.
Mm. Right. So our first thing is they're going to design group work. Right? It's going to be group work, the first one.
So what are the three? What are the three elements that you're choosing from that ladder?
Okay, we've chosen the first co-design. Co-construct, co-design. We are looking at process over product, and we are looking at number 8, which is peer
number
and self assessment.
7 is peer and self.
1, 7, and 8.
Yeah. 1, 7, and 8. Yeah.
Great.
So co-construct and design and. Now we got to make connections with the visible thinking routine also.
Yeah.
Think, feel, care.
Hi, you guys must tell me what I have to type next. Sorry, I'm like, because I can't see you.
Okay. So co-construct and co-design, whatever we discussed, you can just add in there. Please someone share.
We're creating a rubric together.
Yeah, single point rubric.
Single point rubric.
And with a something on the other two sides could be glow and grow. What did you do in glow and what is grow?
Yes.
So they can identify those.
How do I identify process over product?
So
even
it's taking them through everything, right? From the checklist? Elements of a story.
Will you provide a checklist?
Yeah, we created. They can create from. They can create a checklist.
Yeah.
Backward by design. Also, they're creating the criteria first and then going. Then they're doing it.
Yeah. I think there was something else I was thinking of as well. From creating the rubric, creating checklist.
Mind map, or an organizer.
Mind map or a story map, whatever you want to
do. Storyboard, organizer, story map.
Checklist.
We can also take that one third one is that set personalized goals. That also can come. Set personalized goals and plan the process.
Back to so probably that could be a reflection that they take. So, you know, one of the case study that they've there. So, you know, how would you connect to that? Do you connect to any of the two or three case studies? And, you know, if you do, then what are the changes that you're going to bring about in your life story choice? That's just setting some personal goals for yourself.
See the 10th one, student's choice in reporting. Reporting is understanding. Here we are giving him choice. I think we have done that.
Huh? Right.
Done that because in that he can decide with the audience. He can decide with the thing. Yeah, all three, I guess we have done. What I'm thinking about is let's design a checklist also, which they can use to do this peer assessment and self-assessment of the task. Mm.
You want to design a checklist or a rubric? Yeah. The assessment tool? A rubric would be
criteria, a rubric or a checklist. Anything would work.
This is your open-ended task or a close-ended task. Do mention that.
Okay.
Of course, can we have a process over product here? Because we are looking at the process what the child is analyzing, right? So more than the product.
Yeah, you are right. Yeah, of course. Why not?
So should I write all those things which we are tapping on, considering?
Mention that.
Here it is a checklist, assessment, and process and product. What else?
Okay, so I'll just end.
You all have done the PPT? The Google Slides?
We are just working.
Still working on it.
Okay, because you haven't screen shared.
We are all on the presentation.
Okay, one of you can screen share so that it becomes convenient for everybody else.
I can't enter. Who is on slide number 5? I can't enter the third point. Ruchi, are you on saying?
See, now I can see.
Lovely. Limerick, funny form, and
design, constructing, field. Self-assessment, you have to write?
So this is open-ended or close-ended task?
Open-ended.
Yeah. Write that also. What's the
problem? We're also using this thing, use feedback to identify. We said that we're also going to use that. Use feedback to identify.
Yeah, she's adding.
Yeah.
Okay. So you're also going to prepare a checklist or rubric for this? Or are you going to...
We propose that, checklist, the rubric would be prepared along with the learners.
Okay, co-creation.
Okay. Yeah, co-creation. We have put a few success criteria which are for our reference.
Lovely. On an average, 5 minutes left. So just hurry up, please.
Over here now in the success criteria, we have put about the knowledge of poetry, but what about the performance? We have to put one success criteria, pointer for the performance also. So yeah, how is the presentation?
Ashapi, you can add fluency.
don't you think this is more of process over a product? Just instead of use feedback to identify, see if it is more of a process that you're looking at than the product.
Actually, we have the subject arts. So, you know, performance is equally important, the product at the end. So hence, okay, we have not taken.
Okay. Yeah, but I need success criteria for presentation.
Okay.
Because see, the knowledge of poems is there, first of all, then it is the elements of the poem is thorough with the elements. I think the first two are the almost the same. So one would be performance. What can we put a criteria for performance? That their performance is lively or musical.
Fluency and rhythm, na? Or rhyme and rhythm.
We can also use voice modulation, articulation, yeah, fluency, all these come as a part of, you know, when exactly. Yeah. All of them. Fluency, articulation, voice modulation.
I think, Ashwati, the first two are not same, yeah, because we mentioned which type of poetry form they are going to choose. And the second says in that poetry, do they possess the knowledge of the elements of that poem? So they are different.
You have diverse opinions. How did you
students taking action also? I can, like any kind of action also at this stage. Right? So we can also say they are taking voice in the reporting.
Yeah.
Yes, absolutely.
Yes. Michelle, will you present for our group, please?
Nope, yeah. I think so much, yeah, but this is it. Sonia, you present.
No, not me.
Yeah, it's okay.
Yeah, Sonia,
we
you
still
can
have
do
to
it
do the think, feel, share. We still haven't reached there.
Last 4 minutes.
We still need to look at the strategy. Yeah, think, feel, so share.
Can you go to that slide?
Yeah, yeah, I've just. Yeah, yeah, 1 minute.
Huh? Green, the third one, I think it is.
How do I feel about my teaching and learning practice right now?
So we can put that in reporting.
What is my emotion?
Think, feel, okay.
No, I mean, this is use the thing while designing your. Okay, so the thing would come where the act. Thing was that assignment was where we you wrote no the case study that we use thing.
This is where actually we use our thing. Task.
Yeah, so this is the way we use the thing.
Actually, you can strategy just over here only instead of we don't have time. Purti over there on top in capitals, you can just put thing. So this yeah is what we yeah, right? And then we'll explain it.
We use the thinking strategy to come up with this assignment. Feel, we could put it saying that when we looked at the
dispositions, when you're talking about dispositions.
Yeah. What was my emotional response to teaching and learning?
When we kept the criteria in emotional mind to assess them.
Care.
Yeah, when we, so the feel would be when we put down the criteria for assessment, we were looking at the socio-emotional, is that what they're saying?
Yes, yes. The feel, no?
So emotional response.
Yeah.
Last 2 minutes.
Oh my
God. What am I
almost done.
How do I share this PPT with all of you? How do I do that now?
Can you see a share button on top there on the right hand side?
Okay, okay.
Put the
link in. Who's presenting it? Who's you, presenting it?
Sonia, no?
Huh? No.
Come on, Sonia. You're the spokesperson in our group.
I am the chatterbox, you mean to say? Purti, in the share, that yellow thing which is highlighted over there, if you can click on that.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. And I'll share it with.
Yeah, there'll be a link which will
go on to.
Put the link on this chat box.
No, she has to restrict it. She has to change the setting over there.
Yeah.
So I don't want to do that. So what I'll do is I'll copy this link and I'll put it in the chat.
It doesn't open. It doesn't open. Go on, share.
Click. So now where it says restricted to Jamnabai, just click. No, wait. Just click on this.
These are editors and viewers.
Okay. 1 minute. It is restricted to her school. We will not be able to go.
I know. I'll change the setting. One minute. I'll do it.
Here, can you see in the blue where it says share with Jamnabai? In blue. Mm. No, not Kurti. Not yet. Go to share with Jamnabai. Yeah. Share with. Yes. Now click on that restricted. Yes. Now
here, anyone with the link.
And now viewer ko editor kar do. Viewer ko editor kar do.
1 minute.
We won't be able to edit it. Purti.
Yeah, 1 minute. One minute. I'm doing it. So let me share it, no, with you.
No. Hmm. Just click on that share button again. Just click on that again. Hmm. Okay. Now can you see anyone on the Purti? No, just go back. I'll just tell you step by step. See at the bottom left, change is written over there. Anyone on the internet with the link? No, on the click on change. Now go to the viewer or go to the right hand side where you can see viewer.
Yes,
click over there.
Yeah, got it. Editor.
That's it. Now copy the link and put it in the chat box.
Done.
Now copy the link first.
Yeah,
not this.
Then that
again,
link.
Same
share
place.
Link.
Share.
Go to share again.
Okay.
Copy link.
No, don't change anything. Only directly copy link.
Now just put it on the chat. Done.
Yeah. So should I?
No, on the chat box of this breakout room. You have copied the link.
Yeah, so now
go on Zoom.
Yeah, one minute. I'm here. I'll have to stop share for a minute. 1 minute.
Yes.
And I'll put it on chat. Yeah.
Just do the paste. Yes, there it is.
Okay, so leave breakout room. What does it say in 53 seconds?
Yeah, just Sonia, once open and see to it that you can do it.
Yeah.
Sonia, I'll help you.
So, I waited for half an hour. I'm here. Coming again.
You have to log in time. Are you able to edit? Nisha, are you able to go on the link and edit?
Yes.
Oh. Sonia is opening it, yeah.
Perfect, yeah. So Sonia, you can share now and you can be the presenter for us.
We are group number five, no?
Yeah,
yes. We can start with group number five.
Sonia? Okay, let me just
one little question can I ask, because I was waiting to and fro again and again breakout room. I got logged in but I couldn't connect with anybody. So are we going to share something on the chat or something which is there? Then please somebody can make it.
Tina, because you were late, so that is the reason you weren't.
I came twice.
Yeah.
The other link and all that, very confusing.
We'll
stuff.
Talk on personal chat. Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm closing mine and Sonia will share hers.
Is my screen visible?
Yes.
Yeah. So group number five had PSPE, where we chose these three criteria from the student ownership, the 10 criteria, how relationship paves the way for meaningful assessments, collaborating and conferring about learning, and student voice in reporting. We took the interaction strand, where these were the three criteria which we thought we would assess. Obviously, it would be a process. Following rules and regulations, teamwork, and leadership qualities. These are the three criteria that we thought we would assess while designing the assessment. The think part of it, so the think, feel, care, visible thinking routine. Case studies work very well in making connections with the real world and assessing the learning. So a recent case which happened is when in the French Open tournament, player Naomi Osaka, she had anxiety issues towards attending press conferences which are scheduled for the this, and she was penalized. I think she had to exit the tournament. Where this comes in the PSP, it's a social emotional issue. And it's a very genuine issue which some players do face, is about mental this anxiety. So we thought we would present this, and this is just like a sample. It could be any other case study which is relevant at that point of time. The task would be process focused. So we would ask the students, obviously they would be in groups. We would ask them that, okay, a question like this, should a player be penalized for not attending the press conference? What is your opinion? The criteria to assess within the group of the students was how they are following the rules and regulations, what is the teamwork that they are displaying, and leadership qualities. So again, when we, from the point of view of the students who are working on this assessment, is there is a group goal to be achieved. So how are they following certain rules of working in a group? Maybe the essential agreements that have been discussed as a class with the teacher that are in place, which can be followed. What are the skills and dispositions which will help them in taking a unanimous decision regarding this particular issue? How do relationships within the group, how would they help or hinder from achieving the group goal? The feel part of it came that saying that, yes, how do we create success criteria on how to present the understanding that comes from this assessment? And what are the diverse viewpoints in the group? And how did you then arrive at a conclusion? This could also be linked. We talk about skills and disposition. So obviously the ATL of social skills, and maybe the disposition of being the attribute of being open-minded, of being caring towards my teammates. So again, here, I think what we've also focused on is the process rather than the only the product.
Yeah, great.
And student voice in reporting, yes, we had a discussion about whether it could be self-assessment, whether it could also be peer assessment, and how student voice comes through in the reporting, where students may also, you know, design the learning goals, the success criteria, maybe a rubric, and then they can either self-assess, and a part of it can be also peer assess for this thing of their understanding. Nisha, would you like to add something, or anybody
no,
else?
No, you've covered everything, Sonia.
Kornali, huh? Yes.
Thank you, sir.
So I think quick and...
Yes, we have to be quick. Two minutes each presentation. Great. Thank you, Group 5. Group 4?
Well said, Group 5. It was really interesting.
Group 4, can we have your presentation, please?
Just a minute.
And I'm going to start timing. Otherwise, our meeting always...
Yeah, can you see me? Yeah, can you see my screen?
Yes.
Yeah. So group 4, so our subject was art. We have chosen grade 3 level, and it is an open-ended task that we have assigned to the learners. So we had to, we have given them a task of creating their own poem using any form of poetry. And we have given them a choice over there from rhyming poem, limerick, and funny poem, and to perform the same in their own creative ways. So this was their task, which is an open-ended task. Can't go to the next, yeah. The success criteria is that they possess the knowledge of the different kinds of poems that they have learned over a period of time, and whether they know the elements of the poetry that they have chosen, and also to check on their fluency, articulation, and voice modulation. So this is a success criteria for the teacher's reference, but our objective is to create the success criteria with the learners. So co-construct the rubric with the learners. The three criteria that we have chosen from the 10 points are co-designing and co-constructing the success criteria, peer and self-assessment. So once the learners present, their peers will be able to, you know, give feedback on the same of the kind of poetry and their performance, and use that feedback to identify further steps for improvement. So these are the three criteria that we have chosen.
Thank you, group four. Bang on time, 1 minute, 40 seconds. Group three.
Great.
Group three.
The time starts now.
Our theme was who we are. We selected the topic human body system, and the learning objective for the same was impact of lifestyle choices on our body system. To analyze that, the criteria chosen was co-constructing and co-designing this rubric or success criteria or checklist with the learners, which will help them to self-assess and peer assess. Okay, they will self-assess and peer assess using the checklist designed, co-designed with them. And process over product, because throughout the entire making of the checklist and presentation, the entire process would be observed and recorded both by the learners also and by the teacher. The engagement was either the students can create case studies which will satisfy the learning objective, or they can choose the case studies given to them. Yeah. And the thinking routine which they can use was raft or traffic light for reflection. So this is how we think. We tapped on ownership. We included the student also, and the process was also taken into consideration. Let's see.
How lovely. 1 minute, 12 seconds. How lovely is that? And very, very crisp. Let's go to group number two.
Ms. Swati, you would like to speak? I'll present the screen.
Group number two.
Ms. Neha, the birthday girl.
Yeah, I would like to speak.
I'll just share the screen.
Yeah. First of all, we were all somewhere English teachers, not NAT teachers. So we found out, okay, somewhat concrete we could figure out with NAT, EYP educator. So we are all rounders.
Lovely. Time starts now.
Okay. Yeah. The key concepts that we focused over here were, okay, first I would like to say that the age group that we have focused is young learners, and the concept that we are focusing is measurement in maths. The key concepts are form, connection, and perspective, and inbuilt was responsibility, because we spread the entire thinking routine that was think, feel, and care through learners' point of view over here, planning the entire task. Now the think was local things near them to inquire the different measurements. What children find locally in their surroundings, the length, the height, because they are learning, they are young learners. So length, volume, then weight, all that we thought that we can give them a task where they will be making a house for their toy. So co-constructing, designing, length, volume, learners have their choice. Just 1 minute.
I'll
measure
that.
Their own things around them. Yeah. Then set personalized goals and plan the process. Building a toy house. How am I going to build my house? What materials do I need to build this house? All that thinking come over here. The first thinking routine, the first one. We had put it over here. And it is about metacognitive. How and why will they build the house in a certain pattern, feel. Then comes feel for what purpose did you build the house, and how do you connect to your own self? Why do you feel this house would be perfect for your toy? And self-assessment, we have thought that I can measure with confidence. I need to try more. I could collaborate and measure. And then peer assessment, my assessment and my friend's assessment. Both is very important to me. Do we have the other slide?
Yes.
Yeah. Then teacher point of view. Think, planning, okay, where am I? Feel, yeah. Social, emotional teaching and learning is important to the teacher, as each student is important and given a voice to express over here. When they are designing their toy house, they will be experimenting and estimating with the things. It is heavy, it is light, whether it will be, whether it will get wet, whether it will not get wet, all the things will come to estimation of math also comes here. Then care. Students' ownership is the priority. Motivation. Learners are given fair chance to voice choice and ownership. Important. Students and teachers are in partnership of assessment. So we also found product over process over product. And the ATLs that were shown here were social skills, self-management skills, and thinking skills. And dispositions were caring. And definitely when it comes to responsibility, it's caring. Then thinker and open-minded.
Thank you very much. It's over almost 3 minutes. So group one, it's challenge for you now. Group one, over to you.
Can you guys hear me? I'm so sorry. For some odd reason, my video doesn't want to work. So
we can
if
hear you
don't mind. Okay, cool. Just sharing the screen. Guy, our age group, lower primary, it's English and it falls under, it's transdisciplinary with arts, performing and visual both. Our objective under how we express ourselves is the elements of a story. The focus is the students need to present their understanding of the elements of a story. Communication skills, collaboration, creative thinking, vocabulary development, critical thinking and perspective are some of the things that we've noted on. It will be an open-ended task process based. We focused on co-construct and co-design, process over product, and peer and self-assessment. Within the co-construct and co-design, they will create a single point rubric together with a glow and grow area, meaning it's backwards by design. The process over product, because we're starting backwards by design, they will create the rubric first, and from there on, they will move on to creating mind maps, organizers, storyboards, and maps, moving on to eventually showcasing their understanding by making puppets to tell a story in which the elements of a story is showcased. Peer and self-assessment, it will happen, the design of the rubrics will happen in small groups, or most of the assessments will happen in small groups. After everything's done and they performed, their feedback will be given after each performance. In an online learning situation, we can use chat, and we can use the suggestion and appreciation approach, or also known as clap and tip. Clap and tip is verbal peer feedback. So I give you one suggestion, one appreciation. It also connects with glow and grow, which both students and teachers will complete, but which will be part of the rubric. Remember, the rubric is designed by the students. If we look at the FCT, their skills, how they feel will be in their skills development, how they worked in a collaborative environment, cooperated, how did they feel during the performance, a before and after feel. The care is the clap and tip, glow and grow. Thinking is critical thinking throughout the process, collaboration, how well everyone performed and how you feel before and after your performance, as well as how you feel about the group and the overall learning. And then, yeah, that is basically it. I hope I've made it.
Yes,
wonderful, almost, Ari. Yeah.
Almost 3 minutes.
Excellent. Nanta, would you share the screen?
Yeah, just sharing.
So thank you, everyone. So where we all came up with our ideas, these are the 10 steps where we summarize this chapter. The 10 steps to nurture students' ownership of assessment. You could see all the steps are just in a visual, as even Nadia has just shared in the chat with us. So this is just a basic summarizing visual, which we could take away as a takeaway where our goal has been achieved. So thank you, everyone. So where you can see co-design, constructing, VCO, goals to plan the process, where you can see, yes, so let's take away this as the summarize, and we could go at the end. So thank you, Acurious Mind, for a wonderful platform.
You're most welcome. Thank you, everybody. Thank
yes,
you.
Yes, Ms. Nanta, if you could just go one slide ahead.
Just a minute.
You're annotating.
I'll also request all the groups to send their own slides, share it with your peers. This was beautiful work done by each one of you. Next time I'm
Pallavi, can we carry on after the this? You remember I was telling you about the
Yes.
So Pallavi, that e-curious wakelet which is there, we'll just try and organize that and have a dedicated space for the book club, because all these resources are really wonderful.
Thank you so much, everybody, for coming in.
Yes. Thank you. Be the change to bring the change. And please follow the Instagram handle, FB page, Twitter, YouTube, and stay tuned with Ecurious Mind next week. Hope to see you soon with the next chapter.
Thank you, Nanta and Sapna. Thank you.